We all have people in our lives that believe that the whole world is against them. Something's always coming crashing down in their lives. It's always hitting a wall, and there's something that's always going wrong. Or at least that's how they feel. When they call you, you know exactly what you're in for. Venting, complaining, comparing, criticizing, but they never even stop to ask about you. They never ask you, how's your day going? They never look to you to see what you're up to. They just want to tell you about everything they're going through. And even with our best efforts, our desire to help them, our desire to serve them, our desire to move them forward, they're still caught in that bubble and that space. It's so important that we learn how to deal with them, because this can have detrimental effects on us and even our health. Research has shown that even a small amount of negative brain activity can weaken our immune system, making us more prone to illnesses. Negative attitudes can also affect our brain's aptitude for memory, reasoning, and intelligence. When you hold an idea in your mind shared by people around you, your brain rewards you by triggering a release of dopamine. When you disagree with the energy of people around you, your brain sees that as a threat and triggers feelings of pain. This happens even when the idea is negative and doesn't serve you. This means that when your brain is around negative people, it's going to incentivize you to become more like them as a protective measure. The same is true when you're around uplifting people. In essence, you perceive what the people around you perceive. In the 1950s, Solomon Ash, a psychologist, asked a group of volunteers to guess the length of a vertical black line on a plain white card. The results were really interesting. Each person's guess depended on the people that surrounded them. If the people surrounding them overestimated the length, they did the same. And if the people around them underestimated the length, they did the same. People literally saw the line differently depending on who they were around. The implications are obvious. If you spend your life around negative people, you'll start to see the world more negatively. Now, the truth is, you can't always just distance yourself from this, because that person may be a family member, a close friend, or even a work colleague that you can't move away from. Recognize that what's happening to them is that they're facing three types of fear. The fear of being disrespected by others, the fear of not being loved by others, and the fear that bad things just happen to them. Now, we all have negative moments. We all have moments and times in our lives when we're not the people we want to be. So we have to recognize, out of compassion and empathy, that we have those moments too. But what we can all do is strive and aspire for a 1-to-3 ratio. For every one person in our life that's bringing us down, we need three people that are lifting us up. For every one person that we're helping up, we need three people bringing us up. When we manage our life in that way, we're guaranteed not only to be lifted ourselves, but to help others with us. We all know that our complaints, our drama, our comparing, our issues, our negativity have never got us anywhere. So let's try and live a day without them and see where that gets us. Remember, you are not a victim. Life is not happening to you, but happening for you. When you want your situation to change, realize that you've been put in that situation so that you can change and then change the situation. And when you stop worrying about the wrong things, you make space for the right things. Everyone goes through a lot. All we have to do is choose to grow through it.